Hybrid scripting in Enterprise Architect 13. This example will illustrate how to access model information using C# as a scripting language. The goal of this demonstration is to use hybrid scripting to list each and every package that is included in the EA example model. The model pattern includes a diagram to help you build and debug your hybrid script. The class contains the corresponding C# script. The system output window indicates when the application has been built and identifies any errors in the build process. Once you run the application, the system output window is used to display the title, process ID, and all of the package names that appear in the project browser. Now let's look at how you create the script from an existing model pattern. Creating a hybrid script using a model pattern in Enterprise Architect 13. Open the model wizard from the design ribbon. From the Application Patterns tab, select C# followed by Repository Interface 3.5. Select a suitable destination folder to store your C# code and click OK. Hybrid scripting is provided to extend the capabilities of standard scripting environment to high-level languages such as Java and C#. This sample program demonstrates how easy it is to navigate, query and report on the current model using any Microsoft.NET language. View your script by selecting the class on the diagram and then press F12. From the Execute ribbon, I will access a Breakpoints window to help me debug my application. I also need to open the Execution Analyzer window in order to access my analyzer scripts. Ensure the repository interface build configuration has been selected. Switching back to our diagram, we have the tools to build the project, with the results being displayed in the system output window. Exit with code 0 indicates that no errors were found in the script. When we run the project, we can see all of the packages in the EA example model being displayed on screen. Now let's step through and debug our code to better understand how it works. I will start by clearing the system output window. I'm going to break execution at lines 28, 37, 47, and 67. Line 28 contains our first trace statement that indicates that the application is running. Line 47 prints the process ID, and the other breakpoints allow us to observe the printing process. You can use a breakpoint set to group and manage your breakpoints. The execute ribbon helps us simplify the process of stepping through your code one line at a time. The ribbon also provides instant access to breakpoints, the call stack, and many other tools that can assist when analyzing your code. So upon executing line 28, we can see that we are now running our C# application. The breakpoint at line 47 allows us to print our process ID. We can also see that the repository is not null, so in other words, it's not empty. Looking at the project browser, we print the name of the first package called example model, followed by getting started, modeling basics, and so on. We can use the execute toolbar to step over each line of code one at a time. This helps us to better understand how the script works. For example, child packages are published prior to moving on to the next package in the tree. We can observe this behavior by taking a closer look at the modeling basics package, followed by line styles. All of the code included in the model pattern can be easily modified to meet your particular automation needs. You can use code that's targeted to .NET 3.5 or .NET 4.0. Some of the benefits of hybrid scripting include superior execution speed, enhanced interoperability, and full Visual Execution Analyzer support. If you're an expert in C# or Java or other .NET languages, then you might consider hybrid scripting to get the most out of Enterprise Architect and automation. For more information about hybrid scripting or Enterprise Architect 13, please visit www.sparxsystems.com.